वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय मैथ्स क्लास एट जीएम सर का चैनल। टुडे यू विल लर्न हाउ टू कंस्ट्रक्ट द सर्कम सर्कल ऑफ अ ट्रायंगल और सर्कम सेंटर, आल्सो वी कैन से सर्कम सेंटर, कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ द सर्कम सर्कल एंड सर्कम सेंटर ऑफ ए ट्रायंगल। हेयर यू कैन सी अ ट्रायंगल इज ड्रॉन इन विच you can see the point S, which is the point of intersection of three perpendicular bisectors of the sides of the triangle. So this one perpendicular bisector of this side AB, you can say side AB, and the third vertex is C, and side BC you can see one more perpendicular bisector, and one more perpendicular bisector third side. On the third side you can see all the perpendicular bisector meets at the point S. So the point of concurrency or the point of intersection of the perpendicular bisectors of a triangle is called the circumcenter of the triangle, and using this point S or the circumcenter we have to draw a circle which passes through all the vertices of the triangle. So that circle obtained from the center, circumcenter, is called the circumcircle. You can see this circle is circumcircle, this point S is circumcenter, and the radius of this circle is called the circumradius. So we can now define what is the circumcenter of the triangle. So the circumcenter of any triangle is the point of concurrency or the point of intersection of the perpendicular bisectors of all the three sides of a triangle is denoted by capital S, and the circum radius is AS is also equal to BS, which is also equal to CS, which is equal to the radius, and the circumcenter is this, and the circumcircle is the circle which drawn from the circumcenter as a center through all the three vertices of the triangle. So you can see this is the circle which passes through the vertex A, vertex B and vertex C, all the three vertices. It passes through all the three vertices, and you can see the radius AS is equals to BS and is also equal to CS. So this is how we have to get the circumradius. So this radius is called the circumradius. That's it. Now we have to see one example. Construct the circumcenter of the triangle ABC with AB equals to 5 cm, angle A equal to 60 degree and angle B equal to 80 degree. Also, we have to draw the circumcircle and find the circumradius of the triangle ABC. So first of all, we must draw the rough diagram of the given measurement of triangle ABC and AB equals to 5 cm, angle A equals to 60 degree, angle B equals to 80 degree. So first of all, we must draw the rough diagram with any rough measurement. AB, angle A is 60 degree, any rough measurement 60 degree, and angle B is 80 degree. Both the lines will intersect at C, 60 degree, angle B 80 degree. Hence this is the triangle. The construction of the triangle already we have learnt in standard 7. So now we have to draw the triangle first. Put a dot at 0 and at 5. Join both the dots and give the name as AB is 5 cm. Then using the protractor, we have to draw the angle 60 degree from A. Again, the point of intersection at the protractor can be kept on A, and the line, black line, is intersecting on the line drawn AB, coinciding with that line. And from the opposite side, we have to count 0, 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60. Put the dot at 60. Join it using the ruler. Draw line some extra length. And again, using the protractor at B, take 80 degree. Again, the point of intersection is kept on B, and the black line of the protractor is coinciding with the line AB, and counting start from the opposite side, 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80 degree here. So put the dot at 80 and then using the ruler join it, which intersect the previous line at C, and this is how we obtained the triangle A 60 degree, B 80 degree. So triangle is completed. Now we have to draw the perpendicular bisectors. Any two perpendicular bisector is enough to get the point of intersection, capital S. So we have to take any side of these three. So we will take side AB, and we have to take the compass, and we have to take the more than half of the 5 cm. Any measurement we can take more than half. So this is more than half. I think you can see clearly it is more than half. So with this measurement, A center, draw an arc above the AB and also below the AB, and from B a center, cut the previous arc above the AB and below the AB to get the perpendicular bisector. This is how we get the perpendicular bisector. Now you have to join both the point of intersection above and below the AB, and therefore it is the perpendicular bisector obtained. And one more perpendicular bisector of BC we have to obtain. Take the more than half of BC. This is more than half, clearly you can see. Now with this measurement above the BC and below the BC, you draw the arcs from B and C as center. Again you draw the arcs without changing the measurement what we have previously taken. and this is how you should get the perpendicular bisector of BC. Now clearly you can see both the perpendicular bisectors of BC and perpendicular bisector of AB is intersecting at this point, which is again we can call it as S. This is the circumcenter of the triangle. Now from this circumcenter we have to draw the circumcircle and CS as the radius. You can also check AS and also check BS, all the three vertices. Now I have to draw the circle. Passes through all the three vertices and therefore this is the circumcircle which passes through the vertex A, vertex B and also vertex C. Now it's time to draw the radius and measure the radius. We can draw the dotted lines. AS, we can join AS is the radius. BS is also the radius and CS is also the radius R. Now we can measure the radius is 4 centimeter. You can see R equals to 4 centimeter, so we can write radius AS equals to BS equal to CS equal to 4 centimeter, hence the construction of the circumcenter, circumradius and the circumcircle is over. Thank you friends. Welcome friends, welcome to my maths class at GM Sarkar channel. You are learning now how to construct the circumcircle of the given triangle. Now you find the question here. Construct an isosceles triangle PQR where PQ equal to PR and angle Q equal to 50 degree, QR equal to 7 centimeter. Also we have to draw the circumcenter of the triangle. So we know very well that in an isosceles triangle two sides are equal. So we have to draw the triangle PQR in such a way that the two sides are equal and the two sides are PQ and PR which are equal and base of the triangle is QR with the Q equal to 50 degree. So first of all you must draw the rough diagram of triangle PQR. PQ equal to PR, angle Q equal to 50 degree and QR equals to 7 centimeter. Now draw the rough diagram, take the ruler and pencil. Draw QR base 7 centimeter, angle Q equal to 50 degree and we have to draw the perpendicular bisector of QR like this and this point is P. So from P you will get PQ equal to PR. Okay, so this is how we will draw the isosceles triangle in which PQ equal to PR. So now it's time to draw the Fair diagram. Take the ruler and the pencil, put the dot at 0 and at 7, join both the dots to get the QR as 7 centimeter. Now from Q
take the 50 degree using protractor, put the point of intersection of the protractor at Q, and let the black line of the protractor coinciding with the base QR. Now start counting from 0 from the opposite side of the Q. 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Put the point at 50 degree. Join it. Join the ray Q to X as 50 degree at Q. Now we have to draw the perpendicular bisector to get the isosceles triangle. So again you have to take more than half of the Q of the QR, more than half, clearly you can see. Now from R you have to draw the arc above and below the QR, and also from Q as center draw the arc which cuts the previous arc above and below the QR and get the midpoint of QR or perpendicular bisector of QR. Now you can see that the perpendicular bisector of QR meets the ray QX at some point, and let the point of intersection of the perpendicular bisector and the ray QS be P of the given isosceles triangle. This point is very important to remember it. You must know the concept of isosceles triangle, which now I have explained, and now you can see the isosceles triangle PQ equal to PR. You can see 5.4, and also you can see here 5.4 both the sides. Therefore this is an isosceles triangle, so PQ equals to PR. Now our aim is to get the circumcircle. So the circumcircle, by definition, it is the point of intersection of perpendicular bisectors. So already we have drawn one perpendicular bisectors of QR. One more perpendicular bisector of any one side you have to draw it. So let us take PR as another side of which we will get the perpendicular bisector. Take more than half of.
So we have to take more than half of PR. Now clearly you can see it is more than half of PR. So we have to draw the arc above and below PR from R as center and also from P as center. Draw the arc above and below the PR which cuts the previous arc. You can see now we have to join the point of intersection of both the arcs above and below the PR to get the midpoint of PR. So perpendicular bisector is drawn. Perpendicular bisector of PR is drawn. Now we see that the perpendicular bisectors of PR and QR meet at the point, and the point of intersection of the perpendicular bisector is called the circumcenter of the triangle PQR, is denoted by capital S. You can see the circumcenter S, and now from the circumcenter we have to draw the circle. From the circumcenter S, capital S as the center, we have to draw the circle which passes through all the three vertices of the triangle. So now you clearly you can see that I have kept the compass on S, and now we have to draw the circle. Now it already passed through the P, now it passes through R, and now you can see slowly it passes through the Q, and that's it. We have to do to draw the circumcircle of the given triangle. You can see now the circum radius is QS, the circum radius is QS, also the RS, circumradius is also RS and the circumradius is also same as PS, which is already there, PS. Therefore, you have to write capital S is the circumcenter QS is equal to RS is equal to PS is equals to the circumradius, which is equals to 3.5 centimeter equals to 3.5 centimeter is the circumradius, and our circumcircle is already drawn. You can see it clearly. That's it for today in the circumcircle. Keep watching the video for learning and get the clear idea. Thank you, friends.